Yeah, they put their foot on our necks, but we let them, so what you expect? When the last time you picked up a book? When the last time you wrote your own check? Yeah, we all up on IG and Netflix, and the devil, he got you on chill. He's scrolling and trolling your life, you can't see he destroying, cause he got you still. It's your vision that he wanna steal, and your mission that he wanna kill. No condemning, I'm keeping it real. It's conviction I want you to feel. And I'm praying today that we wake up, and the mess that we made, we can make up. It's because of our skin that they hate us. Don't know what it's gonna take to shake us. Listen, and I'm not pacing, I'm just patient. They thought that I was moving slow, they didn't know I was waiting. Yeah, it's my season, it's my reason. I talk with God every day, I'm not into people pleasing. If I ever, I'm for God, and I just want you to know without him, life is hard. So get your heart right, get your house in order.
Hi, I'm Charcy Curtis. Some of you may know me as SZA Diva out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. This is the I'm For God Movement podcast, where we allow everyday people to tell their testimony. Today, I have a special guest, Christian, the man that's behind all the paintings that y'all, some of you may have seen when God first gave me the vision with seeing I'm For God in the cloud form. It's a lady on the beach, but he gave it to me in the cloud form. So the sky part is what I seen. The other picture was the event I do with the Getting Past Your Brokenness with the lady. Her face is half and half. Also, the painting that says, "What season are you in?" That has a big message in it, too. If you look real close, you will see the tree. It has a lot of different seasons. Also, last but not least, the one where God gave me a vision where unity, where all religion will come together and what the brand is about, standing up under one umbrella, understanding about it's only one God. So today, you know, I'm going to give him a chance to introduce himself and tell you what he got going on, because I'm so excited to see what he got going on and see y'all get to know him a little bit better. So Christian, can you tell me who you are and what you got going on? And thank you again for fitting me in.
Thank you for having me.
Whatever,
this is long overdue.
Yes, it is.
My name is Christian Prince. Mm-hmm. I am a multimedia artist. That means I'm an artist using a multitude of different mediums. Mm-hmm. Paintings, portraits, logos, custom shoes and apparel.
Okay.
If it comes to tattoos, I could do that too.
Okay.
Whatever it is that you need as far as visual arts go, mm-hmm. I can do that.
Okay. And like I said, y'all definitely need to look him up. I mean, he brought, as you see, my vision right to the painting. I mean, I thank you again for that. Can you give people information how to get in contact with you?
Yes. Yeah, so I'm on Instagram at artist Christian Bezalel.
Mm-hmm.
That's Bezalel, Bezalel.
Mm-hmm.
Also on Facebook at Bezalel Creation Space Art.
Okay. We're going to get into these questions.
Okay.
So how was it like for you growing up as a child?
Growing up, I was raised in Philadelphia.
Okay.
My father did the best he can. Didn't have much of a support system from family.
Okay.
So a large percentage of my childhood, I was homeless.
Mm-hmm.
Single father. My mother left when I was around 3.
Mm-hmm.
So I never had a relationship with my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Not until later on in life, but with that, a lot of things came about.
Mm-hmm.
And my father did the best he can with what he had.
Mm-hmm.
He was a young father, a teenage father, and it was 3 of us,
mm-hmm.
me and my 2 brothers. But, yeah.
So do you have a relationship with your mom now or no?
I do have a relationship with my mother now.
Okay.
I met her when I was 21.
Okay.
And since then, I have formed a relationship with her.
How was that?
It was easy for me because I was young when she left.
Mm-hmm.
So there really wasn't anything for me to remember.
Mm-hmm.
You can't really miss what you never had.
Exactly.
And I hate to say it, but my father always made sure I had a mother figure.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I understand that.
I got a lot of stepmoms.
Okay.
But I never felt like I was lacking as mm-hmm. far as a mother went.
Mm-hmm.
But certain things that would come from a healthy relationship
mm-hmm.
between my father and a mother figure mm-hmm. is what I felt like I lacked.
Okay, well, shout out to your father because stepping up and taking it apart, because mostly women stand up and have to do that with or without the father.
Right,
so
right.
Shout out to him for doing that. But I got to ask you, how has that affected you, like, dealing with women, like, being that your mother wasn't there?
So, I never really got to see how women are supposed to be treated. Mm-hmm. My father wasn't a good role model of that, like mm-hmm. I said. Mm-hmm. And I just, to be honest, I come from a long line of players and pimps.
Mm-hmm, I understand.
A lot of my uncles, my grandmother, she had a, I don't know what you, trying to be PG.
I mean, you go, no, you go ahead, it's just raw. All
right, so my grandmother did have a whorehouse.
Mm-hmm, okay.
And I saw a lot of things growing up. Mm-hmm. And I took on that. Mm-hmm. So it actually, later on in life, mm-hmm. a lot of things that I learned in that environment mm-hmm. Is what I resorted to when it came to me struggling and having to do things on my own, just like my father did.
Yeah, but I like to say it's no parent book. So mm-hmm. if you do the best you can, you know. Mm-hmm. And like I said, the fact that he did the best he can, I mean, he has, you know, he get rewarded for that. As we grow older, it's what you be, who you be around, and you know how you say you're like a sponge.
Right.
So you know what you take in, you put out, whatever. But at the same time, you know, like I said, it's not a parent book. How important is relationships to you?
I'm learning now, in my early 30s, that relationships are extremely important.
Mm-hmm.
I know it sounds cliche to say it's all about who you know, but mm-hmm. it is really all about who you know.
Mm-hmm.
Networking is extremely important, and relationships in general. As far as, I look at it like this, God wouldn't have put those people around you
mm-hmm.
if they wasn't going to be beneficial to you some kind of way.
Right.
So I think relationships are extremely important.
Okay, and the piggyback with you, some as far as your... You wasn't raised, your mom wasn't around.
Right.
I'm doing, I don't know when I'm doing it yet, but I would definitely invite you. For the men out there that don't have a relationship with their mom and all that, I'm going to do a conference for them.
Okay.
It's going to be so powerful. Oh, my God. I can't wait. God gave me vision and everything. But getting to the point, just to give you that feeling of a mother. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be called the Dear Mother Letter. So you're going to get a chance to write a letter to your mother, how you felt from coming from a young boy's point of view. To the grown man you are today. So I'm definitely going to keep you updated with that. And I wanted just to share that with you or whatever. But
I look forward to
it. Oh, yeah, I am too. It's going to be big. I'm definitely can't wait. God is doing some amazing things. And I understand there's a lot of men out there. They need that. You know what I'm saying? And it really affects men that don't have their mother. They don't have a relationship with their mother. So they paint this picture of a mother. And they look at a woman, they be like, well, my mom was this, my mom was this. When really you tell her a lie, because you painted this woman you never met.
Right,
so
right,
therefore,
right,
it's
right.
more of an image of somebody you never met. But at the same point, it's going to teach them that you can't blame this woman for what your mother, you know what I'm saying,
mm-hmm.
didn't do. And everybody got a different story. Your mother may not have been ready. She may, you know, might have been best thing for her to leave. So everybody got a different story, but just knowing, it's best to know than not to know. But if the word I was a person or the word we was a person, which one would describe you best and why?
Definitely we. Mm-hmm. Anyone that knows me will tell you that I'm all about the people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all about the collective. I'm a team player.
Okay.
I put a lot of people before myself.
I understand.
And that's a gift and a curse in itself.
It is.
I'm just now learning to really put myself first in certain aspects.
Mm-hmm.
But altogether, I would say I am a
okay. Have you ever been in a dark place? And if so, how did you pull yourself out of it?
Definitely. Like I said, a lot of the things that I learned in the environment that I grew up in, I brought with me later on in life. After high school, I was living in Detroit, a
mm-hmm.
Rough city, beautiful city, but it's a rough city.
Mm-hmm.
Similar environment to where I grew up.
Mm-hmm.
So I fitted in naturally. Only thing is, now I was grown.
Mm-hmm.
Now I could take what I learned and put it into practice.
Mm-hmm.
And I did that. And I did that to the full.
Mm-hmm.
And I was pimping.
Mm-hmm.
Had tons of fake money. Just hanging around the wrong people. Doing the wrong things. And although I was raised in that environment, I did have one grandmother that always instilled Christian principles and a Christian foundation in my life. So I didn't know the Lord. Mm-hmm. I always had that in the back of my mind, but I did what I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. I did what I thought I knew to do. Mm-hmm. But that foundation never left me. Mm-hmm. So I can't even take the credit for taking me out of such a dark place. I know it was God. Mm-hmm. I look back now and I know that even in the midst of my sinning, my pimping, my whatever, mm-hmm. I know that God was with me. He brought me through some things. One thing in particular, because I had that foundation, mm-hmm. I knew I was wrong. Mm-hmm. I couldn't sleep at night knowing this is what I'm doing. Like, I wasn't happy with myself. Mm-hmm. I honestly wanted to end it. Mm-hmm. I wanted to end it. I wanted to just take my life away because I didn't feel like I was living a life worth living. Mm-hmm. So I took about a G. Mm-hmm. And I gave it to a known hitman that I knew, mm-hmm. and I put a price on my own head.
Oh wow!
I knew I wouldn't have been able to do it myself, but mm-hmm. I put a price on my own head, and he put a gun to my head, and at that moment he just broke down and started crying, said that a voice told him not to do it. Mm. I went home, I cried like a baby.
Yeah.
Repented because I already knew what it was. Mm-hmm. I already knew. And I'll tell you what, I cried myself to sleep that night. Mm-hmm. I woke up the next morning, and that was the brightest the sun ever been, the bluest the sky ever been. And the same environment that I was in, but everything just looked so different to me. And I just had a new lease on life. Felt like I had a second chance. And since then, I've been trying to do the right thing.
So what would you tell that person that you know, maybe going through something that, you know, that turned it around for them for a situation like that? What advice would you give them?
You were made with a purpose. Mm-hmm. God doesn't make mistakes. It's not by chance that you're here. Mm-hmm. God has a plan for you and a purpose for you. Mm-hmm. And as soon as you align yourself with what that purpose is and what that will is, He's going to take you where you need to be, put you around who you need to be put around mm-hmm. to do what it is that you need to do.
Mm-hmm. What keeps you grounded?
What keeps me grounded? I would say it's a combination of all of the things that the Lord has me doing right now,
okay.
The different hats that I wear, the different places that He has me, because of course, with my family, it keeps me grounded to where I'm not being those role models that I was around or that I had.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to my everyday job,
mm-hmm.
Working with the homeless and stuff like that, like being able to give back, but also keeping in mind that you were here before.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot of things just in life that keep me where I need to be to do what it is that the Lord needs me to do.
Okay. What is something you asked God for and you wish you could have been a little bit more specific about it?
I don't know.
Nothing.
Okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
Yeah.
How did you turn your pain into power?
Now, being in the lifestyle that I was in, mm-hmm. I learned a lot of things,
mm-hmm.
Dressing, mm-hmm. how to talk,
mm-hmm.
Those using those things for good
mm-hmm.
definitely got me mm-hmm. into some doors that the Lord was trying to take me to. So that's just a testament of how mm-hmm. God can take something that was used for bad mm-hmm. and make it good.
Oh, yeah. I like to say He'll mold you into what He wants. Just be prepared and be believer and open yourself up to Him.
Right.
What is something you like people to know about you that they don't know?
I'm an artist, but I'm a lot of other things, too. I'm a husband. I'm a father of five.
Mm-hmm.
I rap.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What is different about the old you versus the new you?
The old me was all about self.
Okay.
The old me had more of a chase the bag mentality. Mm. The new me has more of a I want the bag that's for me mentality.
Okay.
Definitely the old me wasn't applying a Christ-centered relationship to my life. But nowadays I'm trying to stay on that straight and narrow. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. What was that moment like when you realized God was real without a shadow of a doubt? Give me a testimony.
Pretty much that experience I told you about. I knew of God, but that particular experience really solidified my relationship with Him.
Mm. Tell me, you paid Him
and actually having a relationship with Him. Yeah.
Mm. Okay. What's more important to you, loyalty or respect?
I'm gonna say loyalty.
Okay.
Because I feel like loyalty comes from the people that love you, the people that's behind you or that God put in place around you. Mm-hmm. And I could respect somebody I don't even know.
Right.
But you're not going to always be loyal to people that you don't
know. Right.
Or vice versa, people that don't know you aren't going to be loyal to you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What comes first, imagination or vision to you?
I'm gonna say imagination. Mm-hmm. As an artist, me being open and having the imagination that I do allows me to have the vision that I do. Mm-hmm. So I believe that because of my imagination, I have a certain vision, or I'm able to see what's to come, you know?
Okay. What came to your mind first time you seen I'm for God, personally, on a personal level?
First time I seen I'm for God, what crossed my mind is, God is for me. Mm-hmm. So I gotta be for God.
Okay. Leave the people with something positive.
Something positive. Mm-hmm. Trust the process. Something that's been on my heart for these past couple of days is the prophecy has to be fulfilled.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so those rough times, those struggling times, those hard times, it's all a part of the process of getting you to where you need to be.
Right.
So even in those tough times and those struggling times, trust the process and know that God's going to bring you through. Sometimes bad things have to happen so that the good can come out of it.
Oh, yeah.
For example, Christ dying on the cross, that was bad.
Oh, yeah.
That was terrible, but it was used for our good.
Oh, yeah.
And it was bad to the point where Jesus was like, you know,
dang, honestly,
take this cup. If, you know, yeah, if it's your will, take this cup from me. But something good came out of it.
Yeah.
So trust the process.
Okay, thank you again. I will definitely have you back in the future. Thank y'all for tuning in. Like I said, I love you, but God loves you more. You just never know who I may have on here. Until next time, see you.